Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. My name is Claudio. So glad that you're here. Today I'm going to share with you how to create a split screen effect like this right here using Adobe Express. So let's go ahead and dive right in. Here I am at the home screen of Adobe Express and I'll start by creating a project. Click on that plus sign and we're going to choose the landscape option for the video here. I'm going to go ahead and close this up. And the first thing I'm going to do is drop in a video that I'm going to be using for the split screen. So we're going to go full screen and I'm going to select this video I shot with my Insta360 camera. And now we've got a video selection. I'm going to go ahead and show the layer timing here at the bottom. I'm going to mute this for demo purposes here. And what I'm going to do first off is to stretch, or I should say fill the video. So we'll choose fill the video. This is going to be our starting point. And I went ahead and double click because I want to bring the bottom up here to the bottom of my view here. And I'm just gonna slide this through and do a little trimming here to start off the video right about there. I think I'm going to start off in. So I'll stretch this, bring this about right there. And then I'm going to cut this all the way, or I should say split right about there, maybe to the 11 second mark, right about there. And the reason I do this is so I can see this scene or this actual keyframe here. So what I'll do next is add a scene. And within this part here, this is where I'm going to have fun with the split screen, is we're going to go to grids over here on the left-hand side. And I'm going to go to a split screen. I'm going to go to here. So we've got two. And then what I'll do is click on the actual grid here and set this as the page background. I'm going to go ahead also and adjust the spacing and the padding to 20 and 20. So that way I have an even amount in between and around. And I'll go ahead and change the color. This is where you can do some branding. So I'll go ahead with my colors here. In the next step, we're going to repeat the process. We're going to actually drag the scene into the cell. I'm going to use the same one here. And I'll do this here, drag it in here. And I'm going to repeat the process and drag it into this one over here as well. So basically I'm using the same clip. And the reason I'm doing this is just to have a little fun with my video here. And so what I'll do is, again, bring this to about that marker here, almost to the end. I'm going to actually stretch the scene here. I'm going to zoom in, actually, so that I can get exactly where this marker is, about 11 seconds. And what I'm going to try to do here is come over here to this next scene, about the 11 second mark. And this will take a little bit of time to fine tune here. Okay, let me go back to this part here. Looks like there's a rock there on the right. And so I'm trying to replicate that scene over here, close enough here. This might take a little bit of fine tuning here. And so what I'll do is bring this to that marker right there, the playhead. And so that way, when I transition from this scene here, it basically will repeat the scene in the next scene here. So right about there, and I think that's pretty close. Again, this will take some fine tuning, but for the sake of this demo, I'm just not gonna worry too much about it. And then what I'll do is I'll come over here and cut this scene, or split this scene. We're gonna do the same thing. We're gonna bring this over here, give it about 10 seconds. It looks like I'm in this position here. We're going to repeat the steps. We're going to go adding a scene, grids, and this time I'll go with a 3 grid and set the background. We're going to change again the padding and the spacing so it'll match. And again, I'll go to the background and I'll choose my brand colors here. And again, we're going to repeat the steps. So let me go ahead and do that and I'll be right back. We're going to drag the scene into each, I should say the video, into each cell here. So let's go ahead and do that. I have added the video clip into each cell. And again, I'm going to just go right here to see where the actual keyframe, and I'll try to match it into the other scene, get it as close as I can. And then what I'll do is add one last scene. And then I'm going to bring my entire clip into this one scene here. Again, we're going to mute this and I'll go back and mute the other ones as well. We're going to fit the video. We're going to drag this so it is towards the bottom, and we're basically going to return back to full scene. I went ahead and muted all the scenes and the clips. I'm going to go ahead and play through here. It will need some fine adjusting, but you'll see here, we'll go from one full scene. I'm going to go ahead and fast forward a little bit right here, hit play again. And then we go from two split to three split. And then we're going to go from three split back to the single frame. Very cool. To think about what you can do with a split screen effect to have some fun with your videos, give it some pizzazz, give it some excitement. You have events, you can change each of the clips within each of the frames right here, within each of the cells, and change it up just to make your videos a little more engaging, exciting. So here you go. And that's how to create split screen effects in videos using Adobe Express. And now it's your turn to give it a try. Don't forget to hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, click the bell to be notified for future videos just like this one right here. And please share this video with your friends. Until next time, have fun creating. Peace.